I'm Brad Nessler, joined by the coach, Lee Corso, and the quarterback, Kirk Herbstreit. Today's game will probably feature a lot of running because the forecast calls for snow in this battle between the Western Illinois Leathernecks and the Illinois State Redbirds. And we're set to bring you another great matchup in the world of NCAA football. And here come the Redbirds. The Leathernecks are definitely the favorites in this one. How do you think this will play out, Kirk?
Western Illinois is so explosive because they try to get the ball into this receiver's hands as much as possible. And what he can do after the catch is what makes him one of the best in the game. And they'll win this game big.
I'm just not going to agree, Kirk. I'll guarantee it. I'm picking the Leathernecks.
Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He drops it. Number 80 fields it at the 30. He let that one get away from him.
And, Brad, anytime a player muffs a return like that, it sticks around in the back of his mind. You need just to forget about it and move on.
This offense will live and die by their star quarterback. Do you think they'll be able to stop this kid today?
I think a lot of people are expecting him to have a big game, and I don't see why he won't. This kid has played against better defenses than this in his career, and he should have a great day picking apart this secondary.
I'm with you on this one, Kirk. The defensive line is going to have to put a lot of pressure on this kid to slow him down, because I just don't think these corners can stay with his receivers.
Second down. Number 23 lines up as a single back. He drops back. He passes it. Got his man on the run. He's taken down at the 48. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here. And the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
First and 10. Ball on the 48. Number 23 alone in the backfield. With the misdirection, and they'll bring him down behind the line. That'll be a loss of one.
1 yard loss on the play.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 47-yard line. Illinois State lines up with three receivers. Here's the give. And they make the stop at the 41. First and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. The Leathernecks bring in the nickel package. Drops back on first down. And he's got him on the fly. Tackle made at the 24. With that pass, they pick up another first down.
And, Coach, you can feel the momentum building with each first down in this drive.
Yep. This offense is in pretty good rhythm right now.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24. Illinois State lines up in a shotgun set. Again with a carry. And down he goes at the 20-yard line. 4 yards on that play.
Gain of four on the play.
They line up at the 20. It's second down and six to go. They're packed in tight on the line. And he's stopped behind the line. Great play, taking him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Man, he shot out of his stance like a cannon and exploded into the backfield.
They line up at the 23. Third down, nine to go. Three wideouts here. Drops back to pass. Steps up. They brought him down for the sack at the 28. Well, guys, it was the linebacker that got to the quarterback.
Yep, the quarterback should have read that blitz and got rid of the ball.
Oh. they're going to go for it here. The Redbirds set up in the gun. Here we go. He steps up, lets it fly, and it falls incomplete. They couldn't convert that fourth down.
Boy, look at these guys out there. They are fired up. Now let's see if it's going to lead to any points.
They'll go to work at the 28-yard line.
Start the drive at the 28-yard line. First and 10.
Nickel defense looks to pass. Lets it go. This one is incomplete. Poor pass, and his tight end couldn't reach it.
Intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Western Illinois in a five-wide set. Brought down at the 33-yard line.
With the carry, 5-yard gain on the play.
They line up at the 33. It's third down and 5 to go. Look at the throw. He lets it go. Finds the true freshman. At the 40, to the 20, to the 10, and he will score. They hooked up for the big play.
The coaches do a good job of getting this receiver the ball. They design plays specifically for him, like the one we just saw.
And the end results are huge chunks of yardage and touchdowns.
They'll line up for the point after. He makes the PAT. Less than 2 to go in our first quarter of play. The score, Western Illinois, 7. Illinois State, nothing. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And it's a short kickoff. Number 10 fields it at the 27. The offense saw their last drive end on fourth down. Will we see a similar result this time? They'll set up shop at the 38.
First and 10.
The Redbirds line up with a single set backfield. Toss, and he hits him hard at the 38-yard line.
This is a heads-up play by the linebacker. He's playing run and had his eyes on the guy carrying the football from the get-go. Good defensive play.
From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. Number 23 lines up as a single back, stepping up, throws it out there. It falls incomplete. Number 11 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it third down. It's third down.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
Four wide receivers in the formation. Steps up, throwing right, and that one's fallen incomplete. Number 85 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt. It's fourth down now, and we'll see the punt team. Number 2 is back deep to return the punt. Number 36 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. Number 2 fields it at the 40. The offense with a lot of success through the air on that last drive as they moved it down the field for the touchdown.
The
The offense will start at the 46.
At the 46-yard line. First and 10.
Ace backfield. First down, looking to throw. Slips it short. The true freshman has it. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Second down and a couple feet.
Ball on the 36-yard line.
Fakes to the back. He throws it. That's incomplete. Just couldn't drag a foot inbounds.
And it would have been one heck of a toe drag, that's for sure.
You got that right.
They line up at the 36. Third and a foot. One man backfield. Drops back to pass. Number 14 guns it over the middle. And he's tackled at the 27. And Herbie, that was a good-looking throw.
Yeah, and what impresses me is the composure of this young quarterback. He made a great read, saw the open receiver, and delivered an almost perfect strike. Good-looking play.
First and 10.
First down.
Ball on the 27-yard line.
Western Illinois comes out of the shotgun, drops back to pass. Incomplete pass. Number 2 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it second down. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Gives it to the back. He's taken down at the 22-yard line. Number 3 gains about 5 yards on the run. The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. Bunch formation. He drops back. He throws. Complete to the true freshman. Tackle made at the 3.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
Western Illinois hoping to double their lead here as they close in on the goal line. They set up in an eye down by the goal line.
Watch for play action on this one.
Touchdown, Leathernecks. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
And they line up for the point after. And he hits the PAT. So with just under 5 minutes remaining in the second quarter, the score, Western Illinois 14, Illinois State nothing. Get set to kick this one away. And this one's a short kick. Number 80 fields it at the 27. And now we'll see the offense come out of the field for their next possession. First and 10. Ball on the 41.
At the 41-yard line. First and 10.
They'll work from the shotgun. Steps up, looks. Here they come. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Second and long coming up here. Illinois State lines up in a shotgun set. Back to pass. lets it fly.
Caught.
And they push him out at the 31-yard line. That's a loss of about three.
3 yard loss on the play.
We've got third and long here. Ball on the 31-yard line. Number seven lines up in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. And they couldn't hook up on that one. So the defense gets them to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Fourth and long.
Looks like they're going to punt it away here. Number two, back deep to return. It's a short kick.
Back deep to return.
Number two, takes it at the 45. Let's see if this defense has trouble defending the pass again here.
If they do, my friend, look out. They're going to give up another touchdown in a hurry.
We'll see if they can capitalize on the good field position.
First and 10.
Number 14 comes to the line with three wide, hands it to the back, and they make the stop at the 42-yard line. Number three picks up five with the carry. That'll bring up second down. Second down. One man backfield. Leads it to the back. He's tackled at the 41-yard line. Number three picks up a yard on the play. That'll make it third down. From the 41-yard line, it's third and four. Going with the shotgun here. Back to pass. Moves up in the pocket. Surveys the field. He's under some heat. He lets it fly. And he's got it! He's all the way down to the one. He can provide some excitement.
He sure can. And the thing that makes this play successful is the fact that he's on the same page with his quarterback. Sometimes you see wide receivers that don't have their heads in a game, and they make stupid mistakes.
You're right. Then they complain about not getting the ball.
It's first and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. High formation, looking to punch it in here.
And plenty of options on this play, you guys.
And he manages to find the end zone for the second time this half.
Yep, he's really finding his way into the end zone. He's off to a great start.
They line up for the extra point. And he adds the extra point. Over 3 minutes remain in the second quarter, and the score is Western Illinois 21, Illinois State nothing. Western Illinois gets set to kick this one away. Number 80 and number 10 deep to return. He kicks it. Number 80 fields it at the 26.
You guys remember what this offense did the last time they had the ball?
They had the ball before?
Exactly. It was three and out so fast they had to ask for slow-mo replay to recap it.
They'll start this drive at the 37.
At the 37-yard line. First and 10.
Number 23, alone in the backfield. There's a play fake. He's looking. Throws. Incomplete pass.
Calm down, sweetheart. Quit thinking so much and just throw the football.
I don't know if he's thinking too much. He just let that pass get away from him.
No, no. I can tell when a quarterback is thinking too much. Just take the snap, drop back, and fire it. You're all right if you do that. I promise you.
Drops back to pass. He delivers. It falls incomplete. He had to get rid of that one in a hurry.
The defensive coordinator cooked up a good blitz package that time, and although it didn't result in a sack, it forced a bad throw.
It's third down and 10. Ball on the 37.
37-yard line.
Illinois State comes to the line with three wide. He steps up. Number seven with a bullet. Excellent open field tackle. How about that pass, fellas?
Well, Brad, the defense was coming with the blitz, and that opened some room for these guys to get open.
Yeah, and if you're coming with the blitz, you better get to this quarterback. Otherwise, he'll make you pay.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Single set backfield. Back to pass. Looks.
Throwing right.
And that one's incomplete. The pressure may have forced the incompletion there.
That defense was about to plant him into the ground. He's lucky he even got that ball off.
Second down, 10 yards to go.
43-yard line.
The Redbirds come out in the ace formation. And down he goes at the 40. Number 23 gets 3 yards on the play. So that'll make it third down. They'll line it up again on third down. Number 23 is the single setback. Nice play fake. He unloads it, catches it. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch.
He barely picked up the first, but it's still great awareness by this receiver to know where he was on the football field.
Yeah, and unlike our viewers at home, these players aren't looking at a graphically displayed first down line or anything like that. They just have to know what yard line to get to.
And he's sacked.
Number six makes the sack. 7-yard loss on the play.
Second and long coming up here.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Illinois State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. Second and long. They line up in the shotgun. On play action. Feeling the pressure. And they couldn't hook up on that one.
Yo, you can credit that incompletion to the pass rush. Great job of not letting the quarterback get comfortable back there.
He didn't throw a good pass at all.
Well, that, Kirk, he was under pressure. Unbelievable pressure.
The offense lines up with three wide receivers. Look at the throw. Stepping up. He's in trouble. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. What do we have, Lee?
We have sack number four today. This defense came to play, and I love it.
Fourth and long.
The punt team is on the field looking to kick this one away. Number 36 awaits the snap. He punts it away. It's a high kick. Call for the fair catch. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession. They'll go to work at the 28-yard line.
Take over at the 28-yard line. First and 10.
Set, hut. Drops back to pass. He throws left. Punt. Way to look it in. The Leathernecks are going to take a timeout, and that was their first timeout. It's second down and 5 to go. Ball on the 33. They come out with three wide receivers. Setting up the play action. Number 14 throws it out there. Western Illinois will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. First and 10. Set. number three, alone in the backfield. He drops back. He steps up, looks, lets it go. They can't connect. Incomplete.
They almost got to him that time.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
It's second and ten. They come out on an empty backfield. Drops back to pass. Incomplete pass. Just a little too far for the halfback. Receiver on the play. We've got third and ten. Ball on the 46-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. Looks to pass. He's looking for his man. That's incomplete. Number 81 was the intended target, and that'll make it fourth down. They line up to punt this one away. Number 16 is waiting for the snap. Number 16 punts it, and he didn't get much distance on it. The ball came free. Offense falls on it. And so they'll turn the ball over on the fumble.
Yeah, the ball carrier just didn't do a good job of protecting the ball. This defense took advantage of it.
First and ten. Number 14 with three wide receivers. He lets it go. Number 87 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up second down. From the 38-yard line, it's second down. The Leathernecks line up in a split-back set. He lets it go, and it's caught. Shakes off a tackle. Tackle made at the 24-yard line.
I'll tell you, this receiver showed really good hands on that play.
This kid is always calling for the ball, and if he keeps making plays like that, he'll continue to get the ball.
They line up in the shotgun. Steps up in the pocket with the throw. And it's a true freshman. And the completion nets him very little yardage. Coach, what's up with that play?
I'll tell you, those defenders crashed in and got him in a hurry. No chance to get anything there.
From the 23-yard line, we've got second and nine here. The Leathernecks come out in the shotgun. Back to pass. He's going left. It's complete. He's in for the touchdown. This one has gotten out of hand.
Usually we don't see games get real ugly until the second half, when the talent of the depth chart starts to show. But man, we're still here in the first half, and it's already looking like a blowout.
They line up for the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Down to just a few seconds left here before the half. And our score, Western Illinois, 28. Illinois State, nothing. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Short kickoff. Number 34 fields it at the 27. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. It's first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. First and 10. Number 7 is back in the gun, drops back to pass, looking, and he's hammered as he lets it go. They got to him as he was throwing that time.
He's lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Either that or sacked. I don't know how he got rid of the ball.
Right.
So it's second and ten.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Back to pass. Steps up. He throws left. Intercepted. And he might take this. The 10. And he gets the touchdown. And that interception might be what they needed to get back in this ball game.
Nice try, Brad. Keep their hopes up, but I don't think they have a chance of winning this. They're too far down to catch up.
They'll line up for the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. After one half of play, this one is not even close. Our score, Western Illinois, 35, Illinois State, nothing. We're ready to start the second half as the teams are lined up for the kickoff. Kicks it away. Number two fields it at the 26. Across midfield, at the 40, at the 30, to the 20, to the 10. They return it all the way for the touchdown. And they give up the touchdown.
I'd hate to be going to the sideline and have to face my teammates and the coach after giving up a touchdown like that.
Now they'll try to tack on the extra point. And he hits the PAT. So with under 5 minutes left in the third quarter, our score, Western Illinois, 42. Illinois State, nothing. Western Illinois lines up for the kickoff. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. Number 11 fields it at the 27. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. First and 10. Ball on the 35.
Start the drive at the 35-yard line. First and 10.
Single set backfield. On play action. He's rolling right. He throws it. Number four picks it off. Kirk, any thoughts on why they've had such an off day?
Well, it's been all about making mental mistakes out there, and that interception was another perfect example.
And they'll take over at midfield. The Leathernecks go with the I formation. Look at the throw. Steps up. Lets it fly. Found his man. And he's all the way down to the 20-yard line. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20. In the red zone again. Let's see if it'll be another touchdown. Tackle at the 19-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
1 yard gain on the play.
Second and 9. Ball on the 19-yard line.
19-yard line.
He'll get it again. A little juke. He's taken down at the 12-yard line. He takes the handoff and responds with a 7-yard gain.
Hey,
They line up at the 12. It's third down and two to go. There's a play fake. Looks. Fires to the end zone. And that one's incomplete. He overthrew the intended receiver.
Oh, boy. They take a shot here at the end zone, and he just let that one get away from him.
They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. This will be about a 29-yard field goal attempt. This will just add insult to injury. It's up. And it's good. Western Illinois is lining up to kick this one off.
Illinois is lined up for the kickoff.
Short kickoff. Number 11 fields it at the 27. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. Play action. He passes it. Number 10 with the interception. And they come up with another turnover.
Yeah, the defense is playing very opportunistic out there today. That was their third interception of the game.
They'll go to work at the 44-yard line.
First and 10.
Here's the halfback. Big opening. To the 20. To the 10. They get on the board again. Touchdown. So the halfback comes away with his third rushing score of the day.
This guy's been a very big factor in this game today, Coach.
Yes, this would be a different game if he wasn't on the field. He's accounted for 18 points today. Not bad for a day's work.
And they line up for the point after. He makes the PAT. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter, our score, Western Illinois, 52, Illinois State, nothing. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And it's a short kickoff. And he muffed it. Number 80 takes it to 28. Coach, I think he just took his eyes off that one.
Oh, yeah. You just can't do things like that.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 29. Number 23, the lone back, drops back on first down. He throws left. This one is incomplete. Number 10 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it second down. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 29. Illinois State comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Back to pass. He passes it. Complete. And he's taken down at the 36. Nice little catch there, huh, Coach?
Yeah, that was a good call. I like that call. I like short passes. They're safe and can lead to some really good yardage.
They line up at the 36. Here's a third and three. Throws it. And this one falls incomplete. Now it's going to be fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture perfect three and out. Good series for these guys.
Fourth and three. Illinois State ready to put this one away. Number 85 is back deep to return. Number 36 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. And they'll down it at the 28. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six.
I think they'll continue to pound it out, Brad. This offensive line is doing a great job of blocking, and their running backs are finding all the holes.
If it's not broken, don't fix it. I agree. I think they're going to keep pounding it in there until this defense can stop them.
With the game well in hand, they're going to get the other quarterback some playing time. Got it to his receiver. That one worked pretty well.
It's a good job here by the wide receiver to get open. He created good separation from the defense.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 45. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown. 6 yard pickup.
Gain of six on the play.
From the 49 yard line, it's second and four. Six DBs in the lineup. Drops back to pass. Lets it go. And that one's fallen incomplete. Number 85 was the intended target on the play. So that'll make it third down. Third and four. Ball on the 49-yard line. Setting up the play action. Guns it across the middle. Incomplete pass. Western Illinois ready to put this one away. Number 16 awaits the snap. Number 16 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Signals for a fair catch. The offense gets ready to start a new drive as they just couldn't get anything going on their last possession, going three and out. This drive will start at the 26.
At the 26-yard line. First and 10.
The Leathernecks line up with six defensive backs. Number 7 passes.
Wow, did he take a hit?
Yes, my friend, but he's got to make those catches if he wants to play tight end in the big leagues. Otherwise, just gain a few pounds and become, yo, an offensive lineman.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. The Redbirds come out in a bunch formation on the ground with the tailback.
The defense just blew that one up in the backfield.
Just nowhere to run on that play, Coach. The halfback had nowhere to go from the get-go.
Here's third and 11. Ball on the 25. He's looking to pass. Across the middle. That's incomplete. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
Receiver on the play.
Fourth and 11. Looks like they're going to punt it away here. Number 36 is waiting for the snap.
Number 85.
It's away. Short punt. And he hits him hard at the 47-yard line. I don't know if you guys saw this, but the coach gave his offense quite a speech before he sent him out there.
Now, let's not forget, they had some things clicking the last time out. He's probably just reminding them to finish the job this time.
They'll set up shop at the 47. Number 26 is the single setback. He looks to throw on first down. Looking, he delivers. And this one falls incomplete. Number 81 was the intended receiver on that pass. So that'll make it second down. from the 47-yard line. Second down. Illinois State brings in the nickel here. Play fake. He flings it over the middle.
Caught.
To the 20. To the 10. And it pays off. Touchdown.
Terrific pass, and the wideout hauls it in for the touchdown.
Brad, the wide receiver's route was the key on that play.
You're right, Kirk. This route running really has improved, and the quarterback has been throwing his weight a lot more.
Here's the kicking team to try the extra point. And he adds the extra point. Just over a minute to go here in the third quarter. And the score, Western Illinois, 59. Illinois State, nothing. They're ready for the kickoff. Kicks it off. And he muffed it. Number 10 fields it at the 27. Kirk, he broke the cardinal rule there. He ran without the football.
You know, as a return man, your first responsibility is to catch the ball and then worry about the return. He just lost his concentration there.
The offense will start at the 38.
First and 10.
Off up the middle. They'll bring him down at the 39. 1 yard on the play. They line up at the 39. Second down and 9 to go. The defense sets up in the nickel. Feeds it to the back. He tackles him for a loss. No place to go that time, and the offense loses a yard or two.
Nice job of plugging up all the gaps and the possible cutback lanes by the defense.
They line up at the 38. Third down. Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. Steps up in the pocket. Here's the long ball, left side. Batted ball. And that one's incomplete. He almost had the completion.
Yeah, but the defense was ready and were able to get a hand on the pass and bring up fourth down.
Fourth and 10.
They line up to punt this one away.
38-yard line.
Number 85 is back to receive. Number 36 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. Number 85 fields it at the 39.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
So if I'm the coach, I'm telling my defensive lineman to get more pressure on that quarterback, please.
They'll go to work at the 45. They'll throw on first down. Looking. Slings it. And that one's fallen incomplete. Pressure that time, and he was forced into throwing before he wanted to.
Wow, the kid just avoided getting smacked on that one.
It's second and 10.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
Western Illinois in a 5-wide set. He's tackled at the 48.
12 on the run, 7-yard gain on the play.
Unless we see some sort of miracle, this one's pretty much over. Heading to the fourth. Our score, Western Illinois, 59. Illinois State, nothing. Third down and 3 coming up.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
Number 26 is the deep back as they line up in the eye with the throw. They can't connect. Incomplete. Well, the defense stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get 3 and out and now get the offense back on the field.
Western Illinois, ready to punt this one away. Number 38, back deep to return.
Number 16,
punts it, and he didn't get much distance on it. Number 38 takes it to 25. Not a very good series for this offense on their last drive as they were forced into a three and out.
Boy, oh boy, they had nothing going last time.
Yeah, maybe, Scooter, you need to get out there and show them what you're made out of.
Somebody get me a helmet quickly.
They'll get the ball here at the 24-yard line. The Redbirds line up with a single set back to you. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Number 56 makes the sack. 3-yard loss on the play.
Second down.
Ball on the 21-yard line.
The Redbirds come out in the ace formation. They'll give it off here. They didn't let him get anything going on that play.
No, they didn't. Heck, they didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Third and 14 coming up here. Ball on the 20. He drops back. Let's it fly. And it's picked off. And he's tackled at the 20-yard line. What is going on here, guys?
They've just been outplayed and outcoached out there today.
Anything and everything has gone wrong today, Kirk. There's not much else you can do except pack it up and try again next week.
The quarterback couldn't have asked for much better field position than where they're at now. The defense lines up with 6 DBs. He looks to throw on first down.
Dives and caught.
Whoa.
He looked like Superman making that catch. What a great grab.
First down. They're in the red zone again, but this time they should be thinking touchdown. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Nice tackle to bring him down before he got back to the line of scrimmage.
Solid effort there to break up that play.
From the 7-yard line, it's second down. And he's taken down at the 5-yard line. 2-yard carry by the fullback. It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. They put everyone up on the line. On play action. Throws it. Touchdown, Western Illinois.
A lot of people are going to see this as running up the score, but I'm sure this coach will tell you he's just running his offense.
I don't want to hear it. He knows he can just run the football and get out of here with a win. There is no reason in the world for him throwing touchdown passes at this time of the game.
And they line up for the point after. He makes the PAT. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Western Illinois 66, Illinois State nothing. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And this one's a short kick. Number 10 fields it at the 27. Fumbles the ball. And they fall on the loose ball. And a big change in momentum right here, Kirk.
And you know what? When the other offense takes the field, I say they go for the home run on the very first play.
I like your thinking, Kirk. They always say a defense is most vulnerable after a turnover.
That's right, Coach. If I were calling the shots, that's what I would do.
Ball on the 48.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball right around midfield. And they make the stop at the 46. Two-yard carry by the fullback. Second and eight coming up here.
Ball on the 46-yard line.
Western Illinois lines up in a goal line set, gives it off. And he's tackled at the 42-yard line. The fullback gains about 4 yards there. From the 42-yard line, third down, 4 yards to go. The halfback with a carry. A little juke. And he's tackled in the open field. How about that conversion on third down?
Good push here by the guys up front, and they are really starting to work hard in the trenches.
Let me tell you something. The biggest compliment you can give a coach is that his team is playing hard. And you're right. These guys are playing real hard right now.
First and 10. He's tackled at the 31-yard line. Number 26 gains about 2 yards on the run. From the 31-yard line, second down. They come out in a goal line set. It's the tailback. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Number 26 gets 6 yards on the carry. That'll make it third down. Congratulations to our players of the game. These guys were playing on a very high level today. They line up in the jumbo set. They'll try to get the first on the ground. They'll bring him down at the 21. And it looks like he got the first down.
I'll tell you what, Brad, that is very close. I didn't think he was going to make it there, Coach.
Kirk, I agree with you 100%. I thought he was stopped short, too. This kid shows some real determination on that run.
First and 10. Ball on the 21. The Leathernecks go with the I formation. And they make the stop at the 9-yard line.
Kirk, my friend, this is exactly what you want out of your back late in the game. The ability to keep the clock moving and continue to pick up first downs.
Yeah, Lee, no question. This is the time when you let him carry the team to the finish line.
It's first and goal. They're in the red zone. Another trip to the red zone. Last time, it resulted in a touchdown. And he's tackled at the 6. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. Six yards stand between them and 6 points. They're crowding the line. They'll give it off here. Brought down at the 1-yard line. About 5 yards there on the fullback carry. On the play. From the 1-yard line, it's third down. And this blowout is finally over. Kirk, any final thoughts here?
Well, I'm shocked by the final score. I expected this to be a close game. Illinois State was held scoreless for this entire game, and I don't think they expected that. They need to re-examine this offense and figure out how they can put some more points on the board.
Folks, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you can join us again next time. Our final score on this one, Western Illinois 66, Illinois State nothing. With the coach, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit, and all the EA Sports team, I'm Brad Nessler signing off.